Hello, everyone. In this video, we will see how to internationalize, in other words, make multilingual, a Vite and React application. For this, we will use Intlayer. Intlayer is an internationalization, and more broadly, a content management solution for your JavaScript application. I'm going to take the case of a Vite and React application right here, and we're going to create a Vite application based on React and TypeScript in parallel. I will now install my dependencies and launch my application. From there, we'll be able to internationalize our app by installing three packages. We have Intlayer, which allows the declaration of our dictionaries, React Intlayer, which lets us integrate these dictionaries into our React components, and Vite Intlayer, which makes Intlayer compatible with the Vite bundler, and also provides middleware to automatically redirect the user to their preferred language. So I install the three packages. The next step is to add an Intlayer configuration file named intlayer.config.ts. In this file, we'll declare the different languages of our application, as well as the default language to use. Next, we'll add the Vite plugin from Intlayer. I import Intlayer plugin from the Vite Intlayer package. From here, I can start declaring the content of my application by creating dictionaries. They can be placed anywhere in the application, for example, in the SRC folder. In this case, I'll create an app.content.tsx file, since I'll integrate JSX into it, and add an example dictionary. In this dictionary, we define a key and multilingual content for each element of the application. This is a simple example, but Intlayer allows content to be declared in several formats. Content retrieved from an API, Markdown, JSX, nested dictionaries, or even files from within your codebase. If you want to go further into content declaration, I made a dedicated video on that topic. No matter where your content is declared, as long as the file has an extension like .content.ts, .tsx, .json, etc., Intlayer will compile your dictionaries and automatically generate the associated types. To compile the dictionaries, we use the npx Intlayer dictionaries build command. After running it, a .intlayer folder is created. I add this folder to .gitignore, and then update the TypeScript configuration to include the types generated by Intlayer. FYI, you can also compile dictionaries automatically using the VS Code extension, or every time you launch the application. In development mode, Intlayer automatically detects changes in content files and recompiles when needed. If you want more details on what's going on, you can enable verbose mode. Now, I'll call the content in the application. To do that, I wrap my application with the Intlayer provider imported from React Intlayer. In my app.tsx component, I then use the useIntlayer hook, which allows me to access the contents of the app dictionary. I replace my JSX title with content.title. By restarting the application, I now see the content displayed. Here, test. I repeat the same operation for the other elements. The content is now multilingual and displayed in the default language, here, English. To change the language, I use the setLocale function from the useLocale hook, also from React Intlayer. I create a small button to switch the language to French. I could duplicate this button for each language, but since we have an available locales variable, I use availableLocales.map to dynamically generate a button for each one. Intlayer also saves language preferences in a cookie called IntlayerLocale, with values like ES for Spanish. If you want a more advanced language selector, there's an example in the documentation that is optimized for SEO and accessibility. Then, if we check the documentation, we can go further by defining dedicated routes for each language. This allows Google to index content in all languages. There's an example based on React Router DOM. So I install React Router DOM in my app, create a locale router component, and insert the code provided by Intlayer. At the root of the application, I replace the Intlayer provider with locale router. By restarting the app, I see that I get content in the default language. And if I go to /var, I get the content in French, and the same for Spanish. Next, in this file, I paste an example of local switcher based on the documentation. This local switcher, when the user changes language, redirects them to the correct URL using the use navigation hook from React-router DOM. I import the locale switcher into my app and do a bit of cleanup to remove what I no longer need. Now when I switch languages, I'm automatically redirected to the corresponding URL. One last thing, even in Spanish, the lang attribute of the HTML tag is still set to N. To fix this, Intlayer provides a hook that allows you to dynamically update this attribute. So I import it into my main function and call it at the top of the component. We now see that the lang attribute and the text direction, dir, are properly updated based on the active language. Compared to other internationalization solutions, with Intlayer, you can have one content declaration file per component. This allows for better maintainability and long-term scalability. For example, if you delete a component, the content file located in the same folder can be deleted too, avoiding polluting your project with obsolete keys. Also, with Intlayer, we centralize all translations for a component in a single file. This makes it easier to identify missing or inconsistent translations. Unlike solutions like i18n, you don't need to navigate across multiple JSON files to modify a single value. Here, I can simply write a value and press Tab to autocomplete it in all languages. Little tip, there's a VS Code extension for Intlayer that lets you create content files on the fly, wherever you want in your application. And finally, Intlayer offers a free visual editor, allowing you to manage the content of your codebase through a graphical interface, or even via CMS. This lets you delegate content management to other people. If you're interested, I invite you to check out my YouTube channel. I made a dedicated video on this topic. So I hope this video was helpful to you. If so, you know what to do. Leave a like, drop a comment to share your thoughts on Intlayer, and if you like what the solution offers, don't hesitate to visit their GitHub repo, give them a star, and maybe suggest your ideas or report bugs in the issues section.